morning students. The exercise number 14. Read the question. The wavelength of light from spectral emission of sodium, that is he has given for you 89 nanometer, and find the kinetic energy at which an electron and second one neutron would have the same d Broglie wavelength. Here he has given the condition that the electron and neutron, the wavelength of these two particles is same. Then what you have to find out here? You have to find out the kinetic energy of electron and also kinetic energy of neutron. The condition he has given, the wavelength of both the particles is same here. Let us consider here, this is sodium atom. This one is the sodium atom. This one is the nucleus. These are the electrons revolving around the nucleus. And this atom is called as a sodium atom. Whenever the electron is jumping from higher orbit to lower orbit, it is emitting the radiation in the form of electromagnetic radiation. Those radiations we are calling it as spectral emission. Spectral in the spectral is the indicating that the meaning as emission of radiation whenever the electron is jumping from higher orbit to lower orbit. But this process is happening in the atom of sodium. Whenever electron is jumping from higher orbit to lower orbit, then it is emitting the radiation in the form of electromagnetic radiation. That radiation, now the wavelength, that wavelength is equal to 589 nanometer. Then you have to find out the kinetic energy of electron. Whenever the electron is moving from one orbit to another orbit, then what is the kinetic energy of that electron? And next, second one, what is the kinetic energy of neutron? But the condition he has given, both electron and neutron have the same wavelength. The solution, first one, the general formula we know well, that is kinetic energy of any particle, that is equal to 1 by 2 m into v square. Here you have to find out kinetic energy. Let us take, this is the equation number 1. The d Broglie wavelength of any particle is calculated by, is given by the formula as lambda is equal to h by p. Here p can also be written as p is equal to m into v here. And let us consider we have to find kinetic energy. And here for electron, mass we know, but velocity we don't know. That's why first we have to find out the velocity of the electron. By using this relation, we have to find out velocity. Let us consider this can be written as, take V this side, V is equal to H divided by M as it is, lambda taken in denominator, and substitute all the values, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Divided by mass of electron, you know very well, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. And lambda value, he has given for sodium spectral light, that is 589 nanometer. That is 589 into nanometer in the sense, that is 10 to the power minus 9. And calculate the velocity of electron. Velocity of electron, that becomes, that is, or else we have to find out lambda can be velocity is equal to h by m into lambda, and here h divided by m we ask this. Instead of finding this value, directly we have to substitute this v in the equation 1. Substitute v in equation 1. But here v square is there. But take the square of this one, v square is equal to h square, m square, and v square. This is not v, this is lambda. And equation 1 becomes, that is, kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 m as it is, we can write as, that is, h square divided by m square into lambda square. Substitute all the values, then you are getting 1 by 2 mass of electron 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg into Planck's constant 6.626 6 into 10 to the power of minus 34 whole square divided by here take this one m as it is mass of electron here mass of electron is this mass of electron square this is lambda square 1 m and m square getting cancelled and substitute lambda value 1 by 2 into 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 whole square divided by 1 m as it is its value is equal to 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 into lambda value that is 589 into 10 to the power minus 9 whole square calculate the value by getting kinetic energy is equal to that is the answer 6.95 into 10 to the power minus 22 this is kinetic energy of electron and next one what is the kinetic energy of neutron what the condition we are given wavelength of neutron is equal to wavelength of electron means for the calculation of kinetic energy of neutron also we have to use 589 nanometer same formula you can use here that is kinetic energy of neutron that is equal to 1 by 2 mass of neutron you have to take because we are going to find out the kinetic energy of neutron that's why you have to take the value of neutron mass then h square divided by mn square lambda n square mn mn getting cancelled kinetic energy becomes 1 by 2 that is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 whole square divided by 1 mn as it is and you know very well mass of neutron is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg substitute 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg into lambda value that is the lambda value is same as that of the electron that is 589 into 10 to the power of minus 9 whole square calculate all the values you are getting the kinetic energy of neutron that becomes 3.78 into 10 to the power of minus 28 joule minus 28 joule in both the solutions the formula is same only you have to change the mass of electron here and mass of neutron here this is kinetic energy of electron and this is kinetic energy of neutron exercise number 15 this is read the question what is the uniformly wavelength of first one A bullet of mass 0.04 kg traveling at a speed of 1 km per second. Second one, a ball of mass 0.060 kg moving at a speed of 1 meter per second. Third one, a dust particle of mass 10 to the power minus 9 kg drifting with a speed of 2.2 meter per second. Here there are three sub-questions are there. What you have to find out? First one, the uniform wavelength of bullet. Second one, ball. Third one, dust particle. Let us consider. This one is the bullet. This one is the bullet. Whenever this bullet is moving from one point to another point, it is moving in the form of waves. It is moving in the form of waves. Those waves are we are going to call it as de Broglie waves. And you need to find out what is the wavelength of this bullet. Same second one, the ball is moving from one point to another point. Whenever it is moving in the form of waves, you have to find out the wavelength of one wave. And dust particle also. And the first one for bullet, we know general formula that is de Broglie wavelength. De Broglie wavelength, you know that de Broglie wavelength that is lambda is equal to h by p. But momentum E has not given. But instead of E, momentum can be written as mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. This is for bullet. Velocity of bullet, mass of bullet. Just substitute. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second divided by mass of the bullet he has given that is 0.040 kg into The speed is given that is 1 km per second. Convert in terms of meter, 1 km means that is 1000 meter per second. And calculate the answer.
You are getting the answer that is equal to
1.65 into 10 to the power of minus 35 meter. This is first one. Similarly, you have to find out second one. That is lambda is equal to h by mass of ball into velocity of ball. You have to find out all the values. And the answer should be 1.1 into 10 to the power minus 32 meter. And for C, third one lambda is equal to h by mass of dust particle and velocity of dust particle. That is lambda is equal to, find out the answer, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 divided by mass given, that is 1 into 10 to the power minus 9 into speed 2.2 meter per second. Calculate the answer. The lambda per dust particle you should think,
that is 3 into 10 to the power minus 35 meter.
And this is the lambda value for second one, this is the lambda value for ball. And next, 11 from 16. Exercise number 11.16. Read the question. An electron and proton each have the wavelength that is 1 nanometer. The condition he has given, that is electron and proton have the wavelength value that is the same. And find their momentum. Second one, energy of the proton, and third one, kinetic energy of the electron. The prediction he has given, the wavelength of proton is equal to wavelength of, not a proton, proton. Wavelength of proton and wavelength of electron, that is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meter. He has given in terms of nanometer, convert in terms of meter, you are taking. You have to find out, first one, the momentum of electron and proton, you have to find out. First one, solution, momentum of proton as well as electron, because the momentum of proton and electron both are same, because the value of wavelength of proton as well as electron is same, in the sense the momentum should be same. That is, we know that d will be wavelength, lambda is equal to h by p. We have to find out momentum. P is equal to h by lambda, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second divided by lambda value, that is 10 to the power minus 9. Calculate the value. That value should be 6.626 into 10 to the power of minus 25 kg meter per second. This is equal to momentum of electron or momentum of proton. For both the particles, the momentum is same because the lambda is same. And the second one, what you have to find out? Energy of proton, not the energy of electron. Energy of proton, that is E is equal to H mu, Planck's constant, you know very well. Here E is equal to H as it is, mu can be written as C by lambda. Lambda value here is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. C3 into 10 to the power 8, whole divided by lambda value 10 to the power of minus 10. Calculate the energy value. This will becomes, that is 1.24 into 10 to the power plus 3. Calculate the answer by getting this one. And this can also be written as 1.24. This is nothing but kilo. This is kilo electron. Just you can convert. Or else you are getting the answer. That is, if you calculate this answer, you are getting the answer in terms of joule. After calculation, we are getting the answer in terms of joule, but we don't want the answer in terms of joule. We want the answer in terms of electron volt. If you want to have the answer in terms of electron volts, just you made it 1.26 into 10 to the power minus 34 into 3 into 10 to the power 8 whole divided by 10 to the power minus 9, then divide by the number as 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 90. If you divide by this number, then joule can be converted into electron volt. And calculate the answer by getting 1.24 into 10 to the power of plus 3 electron volt. Plus 3 in the sense that is kilo. E is equal to 1.24 kilo electron volt. This is energy of photon. And third one, what is the kinetic energy of electron? The kinetic energy of electron, the formula you know very well, that is 1 by 2 mv square. But V value we don't know, then what do we do here? Here, multiply m on both sides. Multiply m on both sides. Then kinetic energy delta, that is m into k, this is equal to 1 by 2 m square and x square. Then here the kinetic energy m into k is equal to, this can be written as p square divided by 2, because we know very well p is equal to m square. If you square on both sides, p square is equal to m square and x square. Yes, m square and b square can be written as b square. I substituted b square as this, this value divided by 2. And k can be written as b square divided by 2m. Momentum value of already found out, that is this much. Substitute the value of momentum 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 20 equal to root square divided by 2 into, this is the mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Then the answer becomes kinetic energy of the electron.
You have to calculate. That answer becomes 2.415 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joule.
If you want to convert this in terms of electron, just divide by 2.415 into 10 to the power minus 19, divide by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, these two getting cancelled, and kinetic energy of electron becomes, that is 1.51 electron. 1.51 electron. Because that is the conversion of joule to electron. Exercise number 17. Read the question. For what kinetic energy of the electron will be associated with d Broglie wavelength? The d Broglie wavelength he has given, that is 1.40 into 10 to the power of minus 7. You have to find out. Also, we have to find out the d Broglie wavelength of neutron in thermal equilibrium with matter having an average kinetic energy. That average kinetic energy with respect to our temperature, we can calculate by using the formula, that is 3 by 2 k into t. K is a Boltzmann constant and t is the absolute temperature he has given. Let us consider what is the meaning of the question. For what kinetic energy of the neutron will be associated with the d Broglie wavelength? Let us consider. The neutron is moving from one point to another point. Its wavelength value he has given. Its wavelength is equal to, that is 1.40 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. Whenever this neutron is moving from one point to another point, it is having this much of wavelength. In order to get this much of wavelength, in what kinetic energy it has to be moved? Means, we have to find out the kinetic energy of that neutron. Its wavelength is equal to this much. In order to get this much wavelength, in what kinetic energy that the neutron has to be moved, that one you have to find out. Means the kinetic energy of the neutron you have to find out. We know that kinetic energy is equal to p square divided by 2m. This is a general formula. This can be derived by kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2m square multiply m on both sides. You are getting this form. Kinetic energy is equal to p square by 2m. Here, the d Broglie wavelength, that is lambda, is equal to h by k. H by k is there. P can be written as p is equal to h divided by lambda. Squaring on both sides, p square is equal to h square divided by lambda square. Substitute p value here. That is, kinetic energy becomes That is, P can be written as H divided by lambda whole square into 1 by 2 as it is, into 1 by 2 m as it is. Substitute all the values, 6.626 into 10 to the power of minus 34 divided by lambda value. That is, he has given that is 1.40 into 10 to the power minus 9 bracket square into 1 by 2. Here mass is, this is mass of neutron. Mass of neutron is equal to mass of proton, that is 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. Calculate, you are getting the answer that kinetic energy becomes, that is 6.7 into 10 to the power of minus 21 joule. Whenever the neutron is moving from one point to another point, if it is moving with this much kinetic energy, then its wavelength becomes 1.20 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. And next one, second one, also find the de-Broglie wavelength of neutron. The de-Broglie wavelength of neutron, this is second case. Whenever the neutron is moving in presence of the temperature, that temperature is equal to 300 Kelvin. In the first year topic, that is kinetic area of gases. As you know very well, what is the relation between kinetic energy and temperature? Temperature, if you increase the temperature, then kinetic energy of any particle goes on increases. Whenever the neutron is moving, if you increase the surrounding temperature, that is 300 Kelvin, then its wavelength goes on increases. Wavelength goes on decreases. Why it increases? Whenever the particle speed increases, its wavelength goes on decreases. Whenever the particle is moving with the temperature is equal to 300 degree Kelvin, then its wavelength is changes. That wavelength we have to be find out. But with respect to our temperature, the kinetic energy can be calculated by using another formula. This formula you already studied in the first year, that is kinetic area of gases, that is 3 by 2 K into T. In terms of temperature, the kinetic energy of any particle can be calculated by using 3 by 2 K into T. Again, you have to find out B. When neutron is moving with the temperature, in presence of temperature, that is 300 Kelvin, then its wavelength changes, its kinetic energy changes as well as the wavelength changes. That wavelength can be calculated by using, that is, kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2 K into T. Substitute all the values, kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2 into, this is standard value, this is constant value of all the particles, that is Boltzmann constant, 1.38 into 10 to the power of 23 minus 23. This is Reynolds, this is the standard value, and temperature is equal to 300. Calculate the answer, kinetic energy becomes, that is 62.145 into 10 to the power of minus 22 joule. This is the kinetic energy of neutron, irrespective of temperature. This is kinetic energy of temperature. Whenever it is moving within the temperature, that is 300 Kelvin. And next one, whenever the neutron is moving with this much temperature, its kinetic energy becomes 62.145 into 10 to the power minus 22 joule. Then its wavelength changes. Its kinetic energy changes in the sense, its wavelength is not become 1.40. Its wavelength changes again. That wavelength can be written as lambda is equal to, you know very well, that is H divided by per particle 2m EV naught. EV naught here, this is charge of the particle and this is the potential difference. But neutron is chargeless, that's why potential difference is not required here. But EV naught can be written as, what is the meaning of EV naught? That is kinetic energy. This can be written as kinetic energy. Substitute all the values, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 whole divided by root of 2 into mass of neutron, that is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 into kinetic energy you already found out here, that is 62.145 into 10 to the power of minus 22. And calculate the answer, the lambda becomes, that is 0.145 nanometer. And don't confuse here, this is the kinetic energy of the neutron in absence of temperature. When temperature, then we have to find out the classical formula. P square by 2m. But here temperature is not allowed. Whenever this is the kinetic energy of the neutron, irrespective of temperature, but whenever if you increase the temperature of the particle, then its kinetic energy again goes on increases. If the kinetic energy increases, its wavelength is changes. Means wavelength is decreases. With respect to temperature, the kinetic energy of any particle can be calculated by using this formula. This is the standard value substituted by getting. Its kinetic energy in presence of temperature becomes this much. If kinetic energy changes, its wavelength decreases. Again, you have to find out wavelength. That wavelength can be calculated by using this formula. That is, lambda is equal to 0.105 nanometer. In absence of temperature, that is, its kinetic, its wavelength is equal to 1.40. But in presence of temperature, its wavelength is 0.145 nanometer. Means here wavelength decreases compared to this one. Question number 18. Read the question. Show that wavelength of electromagnetic radiation is equal to wavelength of decoding. Means we have to show wavelength of electromagnetic radiation is equal to the de Broglie wavelength. Before going to solution, remember the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation, that is, we know that formula C is equal to frequency into lambda. This is the formula regarding electromagnetic radiation. Electromagnetic radiation is nothing but simply light. Here the wavelength becomes wavelength of electromagnetic radiation. EM means electromagnetic radiation, that is can be written as C divided by frequency. This is the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation. And second one, what is the de Broglie wavelength? You know very well de Broglie wavelength, that is lambda is equal to h by p. Lambda is equal to h by p. This is de Broglie wavelength. De Broglie wavelength. We have to show this wavelength of electromagnetic radiation is equal to de Broglie wavelength. Means we have to show c by p is equal to h by p. Answer, that is solution. Consider de Broglie wavelength. De Broglie wavelength, that is lambda is equal to h by p, or else p is equal to h divided by lambda here. This is a de Broglie relation, and this can be written as p is equal to h as it is. The lambda value I am writing from this relation, that is c divided by nu. Therefore c divided by nu is equal to, that is lambda. The lambda can be written as c by nu. C by nu I replaced here, and this equation becomes p is equal to h into nu divided by c. And next, rearrange this one here. This is c divided by nu is equal to h divided by p here. Take the c this side and p on the right side. Then c by nu is equal to h as it is, p take on that side, h by p is equal to c by nu. And this is wavelength of electromagnetic radiation, and this is the wavelength of de Broglie. Here de Broglie wavelength is equal to h by p, that is h by p, and wavelength of electromagnetic radiation is equal to c by p, that is c by p. That's why this is wavelength of electromagnetic radiation or wavelength of light, and this is wavelength of de Broglie wavelength. That's why this is the wavelength of electromagnetic radiation, that is exactly becomes the wavelength of de Broglie wavelength. And next, read the question, exercise number 19. What is the de Broglie wavelength of nitrogen molecule? And this molecule is moving in presence of temperature, that is 300 Kelvin. Assume nitrogen molecule is moving with root mean square velocity. The root mean square velocity is nothing but this is resultant velocity. At the temperature of 300 degree Kelvin, and he has given the atomic mass of nitrogen is equal to 14.0076 atomic mass unit. And what you have to find out? The demobile vapor of nitrogen molecule. And it is moving in the air. The air temperature is equal to 300 degree Kelvin. That is solution. First, the mass of nitrogen atom. He has given the mass of nitrogen atom. Atomic mass means the nitrogen atom mass is given. Atom, that is 14.0076 atomic mass unit. But this is the mass of one atom. But he is not given the and he is not given the question regarding the atom. He has given for molecule. We have to find out the demobile wavelength of molecule and not the atom. But this is the mass of atom. That's why you have to find out the mass of molecule here. Therefore, the mass of nitrogen molecule in this molecule, the number of atoms should be 2. That's why the one atom mass is equal to 14.0076 atomic mass unit. But here two atoms are there, multiply 2 here, you are getting this is 28.012 atomic mass unit. This is the mass of nitrogen molecule, but he has given that is the mass of atom. But we need to use this mass, not the mass of this one, because we are going to find out the demobile wavelength of molecule and not the atom. Here the molecule, nitrogen molecule have the mass 28.0152 atomic mass unit. And here convert atomic mass unit in terms of kg. How to convert the mass of nitrogen molecule in terms of kg, that is mn2 is equal to 28.0152, just multiply 1.6 into 10 to the power, that is multiply 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. This is mass of one proton or one neutron. That's why 28 into 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27, if you multiply, you are getting the mass in terms of kg. That is equal to 44.82432 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg. Just I converted mass from atomic mass unit to kg. This is the mass of nitrogen molecule in terms of kg. And next, what we have to find out? Demobile wavelength. Before going to find out the demobile wavelength, we know that the kinetic energy of nitrogen molecule can be calculated in terms of two ways. That is by using the relation as kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 mv square. Take it as the equation number 1. And in another way, with respective of temperature, the kinetic energy can be found out by using the relation, that is 3 by 2 kT. Whenever, if you don't want the temperature, if he has given the velocity in the sense, you have to find out its kinetic energy by using this formula. But if temperature is there, then you have to find out its kinetic energy by using this relation. This is with respective of temperature, this is with respective of velocity. Take it as equation number 2. Equate equation 1 and 2. Equate equation 1 and equation 2 here. That is 1 by 2 mv square is equal to 3 by 2 k into v. 2 getting cancelled. Then here velocity square is equal to 3 kt divided by m. Spherical both sides, v becomes root of 3 kt divided by m. Substitute all the value by getting velocity. That is root of 3, as it is k value, Boltzmann constant 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 into temperature he has given, that is 300 into Kelvin, divided by mass of nitrogen molecule calculated in terms of kg, that is 44.84 8 into 10 to the power minus 27, and this is whole root. And calculate velocity value becomes, and calculate velocity value becomes, that is 526.38 meter per second. This is the velocity of nitrogen molecule. And why we have to find out velocity? Because we need to find out wavelength. But we calculated velocity. What is the reason? There is a formula. Lambda is equal to h by p. But p can be written as h divided by m into v. Mass you know. Then we found out the velocity value. Then we calculate by taking the wavelength of that hydrogen molecule. Substitute all the values. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 whole divided by mass is calculated in terms of kg, substitute, that is 44.82 into 10 to the power of minus 27 into velocity calculated, substitute here 526.38, and calculate the final answer, that becomes, that is 0.31028 into 10 to the power of minus 7. Then replace this point to here, then this becomes 0.028, then this becomes 10 to the power of minus 9. This is remove the scientific notation, then answer should be 0.028 nanometer. This is the answer. Lambda is equal to 0.028 nanometer. This is final answer. Whenever the hydrogen molecule is moving in presence of air with the temperature that is equal to 300 degree Kelvin, then its wavelength is becomes 0.028 nanometer. This is the de Broglie wavelength. It means that whenever the hydrogen molecule is moving from one point to another point, here the temperature is 300 degree Kelvin, it is moving from one point to another point, then it is not moving in a straight line, it is moving with certain variations. What are those variations? Those are called as de Broglie waves. Whenever this molecule is associated with the de Broglie waves, we have to find out what is the wavelength of one wave, that is equal to 0.028 nanometer.